Hello, it's Matthew from Controvite Company, your PLC programming trainer. Today we are talking about timing instructions, understanding types like TP to generate pulse, next timer on delay, timer off delay, and time accumulator. We'll discuss the TP instruction first, which allows you to create a signal pulse of a specific duration. This timer type is defined as a DB block in the PLC memory. It consists of two inputs, IN and PT. IN accepts the signal from the last logic operation, while PT takes in the time that defines the duration of our output pulse. Next, I will show you how to use a TP timer in a ladder program. Our goal here is to write a code that triggers container on a conveyor to move for 4 seconds with just a button push. The project template in TIA portal can be found on our Controvite platform after registration for the PLC programming course. You can find the link to the course below the video. And remember, if you find this content helpful, please leave like and subscribe to our channel for more PLC programming tutorials. Let's get started. Welcome to a new module. In this module, I will describe timing instructions with examples. I will describe timers such as TP to generate pulse, timer on delay, timer off delay, and time accumulator. I will show you practical examples with timers in Factory IO. Let's start with the TP instruction that allows you to generate a signal pulse of a specified time duration. In the memory of PLC, such a timer is declared as a DB block. The symbol of timer has two inputs, IN and PT. On the IN input, we add result of last logic operation. On the PT input, we add the time that specifies duration of our pulse on output. When we use S7 PLCs, we use specified time format. Firstly, we need to add T letter, next hashtag, and then we specify, for example, seconds, milliseconds, hours, and so on. We don't need to add everything, like hours, seconds, and milliseconds. We can choose, for example, only seconds, like here on the slide. Our instruction has two outputs, a Q output that we can connect to the ladder structure, and an ET output, which is the time that has elapsed since the timer was triggered. Let's analyze the operation of this instruction on a graph. When the input of the function block marked as IN is given a high state, the time measurement starts. From that moment, the Q output is set to a high state until elapsed time is equal to preset time. In the next case of triggering the timer, we can see that an impulse shorter than the preset time was given to the input of this timer. Despite the fact that the input state changed its value from 1 to 0 during the elapsed time measurement, the Q output is still in high state. I will show you now how to call TP timer in the ladder program. I recommend you to work with me, so download a project template down below the video. The goal of our program will be to write a piece of code that will move the container on the feeder for 4 seconds by pressing a button. Firstly, add normally open contact to our first network. And type here X start and hit enter. Next, add a coil and type here X motor. Download the program to PLC simulator. Next, start Factory IO simulation. My simulation is active right now. When I press on the start button, container moves. When I release start button, container stops. Okay, I will drag and drop TP timer from basic instructions here in first network. As you can see, we need to connect a data block to this timer. Click OK here. All declared data blocks you can find in project tree. Go to system blocks folder, next program resources, and here you will find all data blocks for timers, counters, and etc.
Next, at preset time, just type here t#4s. It means that the pulse on the output of our block will last 4 seconds. You don't need to connect a variable to ET output, just leave it empty. On the input mark as in, we connected X start button, and on the output we have X motor coil. Let's download changes to the PLC simulator. Let's observe the behavior of our system. I push on the start button, and after that I release the start button immediately. The motor started and the container moved for exactly 4 seconds. If the button is pressed again, the motor will be switched on again for 4 seconds. If I press the button on and I hold it, I still hold the button right now, the container will also stop after 4 seconds.
Okay, that's all for this YouTube video. If you want to find out more about PLC programming and industrial automation, just sign up for our full Siemens PLC training in the link down below this video. See you later!